Gemini, what's good? Welcome to my channel. My name is Anwar, professionally known as DJ Anwar himself, and I do have an Instagram if you'd like to check it out, but if not, that's totally cool, because that's not the reason that we're here today, right, Gemini? Today we're here to take a look into your recent past, see what you got coming in for you in the near future, look at your present situation. This is a love reading. Keep in mind, not everything you hear is going to resonate, so take what sounds like it belongs to you, leave the rest behind. Please don't make it fit if it doesn't fit. This is for Sun, Moon, Venus, and Rising placements. So we're going to take a look into your current situation, get you an outcome, and then at the end of the reading, we're going to go through all 12 signs of the zodiac and see the specific sign that you're dealing with personally, and see what their energy is in regards to the reading. And then we're going to be pulling from the Unsent Messages Oracle deck that I created, which can be found at onwarstarot.com. And these are all the messages between two lovers that have been separated that were never sent. These are the unsent messages. I do take private readings, so if you're interested in a private reading, you can also find that at onwarstarot.com, as well as a little bit of magic. If you're feeling stuck on someone, can't stop the ruminating thoughts, can't get someone out of your mind, you need to evict them from your mind, I have something at the magic shop that you also might be interested in, if you like. So let's jump into your reading, Gemini. What's going on with Gemini? Sun, Moon, Venus, and Rising in love. What is going on with Gemini? Please bring me clear and accurate messages. Gemini, how you doing? You look good. All right, please bring me clear and accurate messages. All right. Situation, clarity, Ace of Swords. The challenge, more swords. Bottom of the deck, someone's not interested. Looks like somebody's getting bored with the connection. Someone's in a situation that's unfulfilling for them. They need a little bit more. This could be you, Gemini. Excuse me if you, when you hear me cough. It ain't the Rona. I have really bad allergies right now, so. Somebody came to you, Gemini, and told you something or made you aware of something that you weren't aware of before. And it could have came kind of harshly. It could have came in just like, boom, sudden realization. You may have had to cut someone off because of this. There could have been some type of sharp communication, aggressive words between you and someone else in regards to whatever this was that you found out, figured out. You could be dealing with another Gemini or a Libra or Aquarius. Doesn't have to be, though. The reason it's all happening, the root of the matter, it looks like somebody is going through a breakup. I feel like you found out something about someone and you're like, nope, not doing it. About someone that you were possibly about to go into a partnership with. Now, you could have already been in a partnership, but it looks like that's falling apart. Or you guys aren't agreeing. You guys aren't in agreement here. In the recent past, somebody came to you with something small. They brought you some good news. Small promises of stability. They're going to take care of you. Everything's going to be okay. Your conscious goal is that you want a commitment. You could have found out that this person doesn't want a commitment, and that's really what you want. They wanted to bring you something small. You're like, nope, that's not enough. I want a commitment. I want this to be solid. Let's change our status. Let's make this official. And I feel like the person that you're dealing with might not want to make this official. This could be vice versa, too. Coming in for you that you're unaware of. Queen of Pentacles and the upright, going to be focused on your stability. The way you see yourself right now is a tower, so could be in a tower moment right now based off of this Ace of Swords. This clarity that came in shocked you, sudden realization. It's like a whoa, I did not see that coming. I had no idea of the tower. This could be a sudden realization, this could be a sudden shock or an upheaval. This could be is equivalent to getting into a car accident or winning the lottery. It's something that you don't see coming. That happens really fast, and it changes everything, changes the game. This is what you see yourself right now. You're in some type of sudden realization. Possibly that somebody doesn't want a commitment with you. Possibly that somebody just – There's a lack of commitment. Somebody just doesn't want a commitment. I feel like somebody just wants to play. It's like they offered you something small and it just never... They offered you something that they thought was big, and once you got it, it's like, that's it? It looks all right, but is that it? The person that you're dealing with, they are holding on for dear life. They're not letting go. They could be holding on to their money. You're dealing with somebody who kind of hoards. And I don't mean a hoard like you see on those TVs on A&E and all that. Not that type of hoarding, but somebody just, they like to keep things. They like to save things. There's somebody saying, like, throw that away. You don't need that. But they just hold on to it anyway just in case they might need it later. You're hoping that somebody's going to make up their mind whether this is you or the other person. And in the outcome, we'll come back to that. All right. I'm talking about the Page of Pentacles. Please bring me clear and accurate messages. What is the Page of Pentacles? Please bring me clear and accurate messages. Man, come on, tell me when. Alright. So somebody stressed out the fact that they couldn't deliver. I feel like somebody really wanted to do this. Somebody really wanted to offer you stability and offer you everything, and it's stressing them out that they couldn't do it. You could have found out that this person doesn't necessarily have everything that they offered, or they're unable to offer. I feel like it was stability. I don't think it was like money or anything like that. It was just they offered you something stable, and it was really small. They could have been telling you like, well, it's gonna build up. Let's get there. Let's take baby steps. And then you realize that these baby steps were gonna continue to be baby steps and just not really go anywhere. You want a commitment here. You want something solid here. You could be dealing with the Taurus. Don't have to be. You want something traditional. Why is the Hierophant here? Could be dealing with a Virgo. Don't have to be. So you want a commitment from somebody who's keeping to themselves, and they're not coming towards you. You could be wanting to go fix something with someone, possibly someone that you broke up with. You could be wanting to go fix that, but you're really looking within and seeing, is this something that you really want to do? It's like they wanted a commitment. I'm sorry, you wanted the commitment, and this person's not delivering it, so you're going, it's like you're pulling back from this person and really trying to figure things out within yourself. You're going within, digging deep, taking a time out from everything, just taking a break from everything. But I feel like there's an apology. Somebody's going to try to work on this, or this could be you. Your goal is to be able to fix this. I feel like you left somebody, and you're now wanting to fix this, whatever this is. You could realize that the person you left is now in another partnership with someone else. That can be this tower here, this sudden realization. Someone they're not willing to let go of. Something about the Ace of Swords. Give me clear and accurate messages. The Ace of Swords. So, you found out that this person wasn't emotionally available. They weren't emotionally ready. They didn't express themselves. You thought that this was something else, and it wasn't. I feel like this happened last night too. The other reading. I don't remember what sign it was though. So never mind that. Talking about the King of Swords. Somebody looks really disappointed here. Something about somebody's mouth is like, somebody's mouth is the problem. Somebody just doesn't know when to shut up or something? What is this? This is the King of Swords. Interesting. Hangman came out for Aquarius, too. So, you're trying to see things. You're trying to see things differently. You're trying to see things different. You're trying to see their side of it. It's just like, it's not adding up. You could be trying to see why if they cut you off, this is mixed. Now, if they cut you off, you could be trying to figure out, like, why did you do that? Or you could be figuring out why you cut them off. And now they're elsewhere. Tell me about the Two of Cups in reverse. So one of you are ready and the other person's not ready. That's what this looks like. Looks like one person's ready, the other person isn't ready. You could be dealing with another air sign. What is this tower about, please? Let me clear an accurate message. What's this tower about? The tower, clarified by the Knight of Wands. You could be dealing with the Sag. A non-committal Sag. You realize that this person doesn't want a commitment. They just want to be kind of on a friends with benefit type basis. I feel like you found out this person was playing. They could be in another connection, and you're hoping that they will cut that connection off, but they're holding on to it. You're hoping that they're going to cut off another connection so that you can go into a commitment with them. I feel like you want to fix something with somebody that you possibly broke it off with, and now you're feeling like it's too late. What is a Four of Pentacles? What is a Four of Pentacles, please? And so somebody's holding on. The person that you're dealing with, it looks like they're holding on to whatever it is, wherever they're at, whatever they're doing, they're holding on to that. And they're not really taking any offers right now. It doesn't look like they're entertaining any outside offers. You want a commitment from this person, and they're not. It doesn't look like they're interested. How does Gemini see this person? You see this person, you're looking back at the past, you see this person as, you could be seeing them as sitting in regret, but there's a sense of regret here. Whether this is you, I feel like I'm talking to a cross watcher. This looks inside out to me. But you see this person as, you're looking at the negative, you're looking at the cup as being half empty as opposed to half full. You could be seeing them, I feel like I'm talking to, like, the opposite person. I feel like you are the other person. Whoever you are right now, I feel like you are the other person. Or not the other person, but you know what I'm talking about? The person that you're here watching for, I feel like that's you. If that makes any sense. How does Gemini feel about this person? Could be dealing with a Leo. You feel like this person's really holding themselves back? They're holding on to something that they have, and you feel like they're holding themselves back, like it's taking a lot of strength for them to hold on to where they are. I feel like you could be feeling like they really do want this, even though they're not showing it, but it could be all in your head, though. How does this person see Gemini? They see you as tired of waiting for them. Tired of waiting around for them. How does this person feel about Gemini? They feel like there's a final judgment call that has to be made here. You could be dealing with the Sag too. But they feel like a final judgment call has to be made. Or that you're making a final judgment call. That you're tired of waiting and that you're going to make a final judgment call on this. Clarify the Queen of Pentacles. What's coming in? Looks like you're going to have some stability coming in, but it doesn't look like it's attached to any type of emotion, any love, or anything like that. It's like hopefully, in this case, money can buy you happiness, because it looks like you're going to have it, but it doesn't look like there's happiness here. I got cards trying to jump out in my hand, too. All right, I just got really cold, too. Okay. Could be doing with the Pisces. There's going to be more secrets coming in. This is going to keep you confused. I feel like this is going to keep you confused. The challenge is, look, you can't figure this out. Like, you can't figure out what's going on. And there's going to be, it looks like there's going to be more confusion. More confusion coming in with the moon. This is weird. Talking about the Three of Pentacles for the outcome. Three of Pentacles clarified by the Knight of Cups in reverse for the outcome. If this person is dealing with someone else, it looks like they're going to continue to deal with this person. You could be retracting your offer. They could be retracting their offer. Please clarify. Yeah, so I feel like the person is happy where they are. Person is happy where they are. You could be wanting to move in on this connection knowing that they are happy. I feel like you're dealing with somebody who's already in a connection. You let somebody go or they let you go. Somebody let somebody go. One of them moved on into another connection. The other one decided, okay, wait a minute. Maybe I do want this, and now it's feeling too late. The other person's stuck, and they can't get out of it. That's what it looks like. This is, I don't want to confuse you or me, but that's what this looks like. Please show me all 12 signs of the zodiac in regards to this reading. Please give me clear and accurate messages. And then all 12 signs of the zodiac in regards to this reading, the unsent messages, oracle deck. Somebody's afraid of rejection. All right, if you're dealing with an Aries, the Aries doesn't want to return to the past. They don't have good memories about it. Letting you go has been one of the most challenging things I've ever tried to do. And they do not want to revisit that. You have to go through that again. If you're dealing with a Leo, looks like that partnership is coming to an end. Same cards here. There's disharmony there, so you guys aren't agreeing. Some of my favorite memories are of you. If you're dealing with the Sag, things haven't changed. Not much has changed. Looks like it's just the same old song and dance, the same old thing. They could be going through some karma. They could be your karma, vice versa. But it doesn't look like nothing is like anything has changed with the Sag. I wonder if you still secretly love me too. If you're dealing with a Cancer, looks like somebody could be biting their tongue, not wanting to say something. I feel like your Cancer really, really wants to speak up and say something, but they're biting their tongue. And I don't feel like it's going to be good what they do want to say. If you would just make the smallest effort. If you're dealing with a... Who is that? Scorpio. Dealing with the Scorpio. Scorpio is no longer watching you. They're no longer curious. It doesn't look like they're... They're not going to be taking any action. I feel like this person's not taking any action. Sorry my energy is so down, you guys, right now. It's been a long day. I understand our connection. I'm just not ready to accept it. Dealing with a Pisces is freeing themselves. Finally, they know that they don't have to be there. They're finally getting the strength and they're walking up out of this situation. I'm aware of what you're going through. I wish I could be there to go through it with you. If you're dealing with a Virgo, Virgo is also freeing themselves. They figured it out. I wonder if I ever crossed your mind. If you're dealing with a Taurus, you could have found out some lies about them. They could have told you some lies. They could be lying to you. You found out something wasn't true. Regardless of the way things appear, you are my wish fulfillment. If you're dealing with a Capricorn, Capricorn's going to be rushing in. I feel like they want to rush into play. They're going to be there for a good time, not a long time. They're coming in with confidence, too. I may have your heart, but someone else has your body. If you're dealing with an Aquarius, you have a victory with this Aquarius. The energy of a victory is there if you guys reach out and grab it. But an unsent message says, speaking of reaching out and grab it, if you want it, time is of the essence. The clock is ticking. If you're dealing with a fellow Gemini, looks like you guys are going to be taking a risk. You guys are going to be taking a leap of faith together. It's not possible to experience my type of love in another human. You'll spend a lifetime searching for something that doesn't exist. And if you're dealing with a Libra, Libra's going to be rushing in to talk. They want to talk all about it. We will be together again soon. I just need a little bit more time. So that's what I have for you. Hopefully it wasn't too confusing. Hopefully it resonated. If not, we'll try again. But please like, share, subscribe. Let me know what the heck is going on in the comments sections. Again, if you're feeling stuck on someone, please visit onwarstarot.com, as well as if you want a private reading just specific to yourself and your own situation. Or if you'd like to get the unsent messages oracle deck, you can find all of the above at onwarstarot.com. It's a really fun place. Check it out. Even if you don't get anything, just check it out anyway. Alright, so anyway, I'll see you guys in the comment section. Please let me know what's going on. Please like, share, and most importantly, please subscribe. When you subscribe, energetically, it gives me permission to tap into your energy. And every time you come back, it'll get more and more accurate to your situation. So please hit that subscribe button, and I'm going to catch you guys on the next one.